Hello and welcome back to another one of my Sims 4 speed building videos, and I'm doing another public lot this time. In fact, today I'm actually going to be building a pub for the Sims 4, and the reason I decided to make this pub was I wanted to make a public lot that was like a nightclub or lounge or bar, because there are so many different ones in the Sims 4, and I originally tried to make one in Newcrest, but I wasn't happy with the results, so I decided I'd go and try and make a bar. I think the original one I tried to make was a lounge, and as I said, I just wasn't happy with the outcome of that. So I decided to do a completely new one and make a little pub, and I thought like a nice small building would be quite good, so I came over to Willow Creek and I built this one at the end of this road, and which is why I've called it the end of the road pub, sort of like it's the end of the day, end of the road, and I just thought it was quite an effective name for a pub. So you can see here it is a small building. It's got two floors, but you can only access the first floor. The second floor is just for the outside look. And I was thinking of doing something in the top floor, like a guest room or the staff room, but there just wasn't any space to put in stairs, and the roofs kept on glitching through the walls. So I decided to keep it as just the single floor building, and I think that was quite effective in the end. So I'm putting in the roofs on the building now. I've got quite steep roofs on the sides, and then they sort of curve in at the top, and I think this is also a really cool way of doing the roofs. It gave the pub building a nice feel and sort of made it look like it was old and something that you would find an old dirt lane in England. Because if you haven't guessed yet, most of my builds are based off English traditions, because I do live in England and I am very proud of my country, so that's why most of my builds look like that. I'm just playing around with the roofs here, trying to get one that looks the best for the end of this building, seeing if extending the building would help in any way. But eventually I just go back to the first design I put in, which was just a regular pitch roof, and I think that was quite effective in the end also. So as you can see, I'm playing around with the roofs here in the top of the build, trying to get it to stop doing the roof glitch, and the only way I could achieve that was if I put a board around the outside, and as I said, it was just a waste of time really, and a waste of space downstairs if I needed to put stairs in. I'm putting some columns in around the building here, giving it a more structural look, and also adding to the sort of old-timey essence of the build. And I do like these columns. I've used them in quite a lot, and I think I've used them in a house build that's coming up on this video, next one in The Sims 4. So you can see how much I do love these columns. I think it's because they're the only columns that get a dark look, and I will have like a dark shading like it's wood, and I think I gravitate towards that more because I like having the darker colours on the roofs and roof trims. Otherwise it just looks a little bit weird for me, and I've got to try and find a way to use some of the lighter roofs. That's what I like doing with the Sims games, is trying to find ways or things that I don't usually do, and try to use them more, and I occasionally get a really unusual looking build, but it still turns out great if I put enough effort into it. So I've actually painted the walls on the outside of this building here. Originally clad the whole building with brick, and I thought that looked good by itself, but I wanted to try something else, so I decided to add in these textures with the bricks and siding, and that looked good on some of the parts that came out. And I also searched through the pure siding walls to find a continuation of the white siding or panelling to go on the top floors. And something I've noticed in the siding and wall section is that all the wall textures that are half brick, half siding, like you see on the ground floor there, all the siding actually has different colours to the pure siding wall paints, which is really annoying. Like, if you look at them, the colours are slightly different, and it just annoys me, but I managed to find this one that looks quite close, so I'm happy with this, and the main aesthetic of the build draws your eye away from that, which I'm happy about. I think I'm coming in to do the furnishing on the inside here. I've got some split leveling going on in this build. Don't think I've actually done some split leveling in one of my house builds before, at least in The Sims 4, which you can do by deleting the foundation inside your build. So I did enjoy that. It gave a sort of sunken area to this bar, or to this pub, where your Sims will mostly drink, and there is also a piano that I'm going to put down there. And I keep on saying bar, that's because this lot is actually a bar lot type in The Sims 4, because obviously they have a pub lot type. So you'll get all the classic bar things here, and I had to put in all the items to make it function properly like a bar, like that long bar there at the front, several stools, and a few toilet things, so I put them in there. You can see on the walls I've used the specific gender toilet doors it comes with a mod called the Locked Doors mod. I know it's not really necessary now that they've added in actual locked doors and actual gender things, but when I built when I built this lot, that mod wasn't out yet, so I've still got this, and if you want to download this lot, you will have to use the mods or replace the doors yourself. And that's something I wanted to address, is in the gallery, because I have used that mod, it comes up as custom content, which means you won't be able to see this lot unless you go into the gallery and check a little box underneath the advanced settings that says include custom content. And then it will show the lot. And I believe you can still download it, and the game will just replace it with different items. So yeah, it should be fine for you to download if you do want to download this. So here are the bathrooms. I just made them look fairly samey and gender neutral, and I just put different paintings in each one. And you can see I've decorated the downstairs area in the pub a lot more. I've got this sort of bay window at the front where I've put a lot of plants in, because I felt I should raise it up a level, but there wasn't really any room to put in, anything. So I put in those plants, and it kind of gives a nice effect. I've got lots of single tables up on the top level, and also I've got the tables with all the chairs around on the bottom, so you can sit and eat and have a good time. And of course, as I mentioned before, there's the piano there. So I'm just going around adding some decorations to the walls and the outsides of this lot. I decided to put in some curtains, and I tried to find one curtains that fit really nicely for this build. Of course, there isn't a great selection of curtain colours in The Sims 4 yet, so I spent a lot of time trying to do this, including looking at some blinds and curtains that were too tall for the windows, but eventually I just left the curtains on the one side of the build and nothing else. Just blackened out the rooms at the top there, and then I'm putting in some furniture around the outside of this build so that you can sit outside if it's a nice day, and just adding some extra detail in. Putting in some lights around the outside to make it look like a popular night spot, and then just some trees around the back to give it a more dense feel, and just make it not look as plain as if it's just in the middle of nowhere. So as I said, just finishing off with the bushes, and I think I'm going into the screenshots, and it's the end of the build. Yes, I just put that solitary street lamp out on the front there. I thought that was also a nice little touch I put in. So as I said, here are the screenshots, here are some views of the outside. I am really happy with the brick effect on the side of the building. Here's one of the bar inside, and then I've got some more shots of the outside around the back. The screenshots are all in a fairly random order today. So here's another shot looking from the front corner of the pub down into the downstairs section, and there's another one of the shot. There's a Sim coming off from playing the piano, and then just some people hanging out around the bar. And I've got two shots of the toilets, I think. I think this is the female toilet, and this is the male toilet, so as you can see, not really much difference, just the paintings on the walls. And then I've got another shot of the downstairs in the pub here, with the Sim playing the piano, and then the floor plan. So, I wanted to thank you all very much for watching, and goodbye!